Call of Duty Warzone. Oh my god. This game is so bad nowadays. Like, it's so toxic, so full of cheaters, so bad. It's just like, it used to feel like this painting that belonged in a museum, and nowadays it feels like a painting that's like your kid made that you're embarrassed to even throw in the refrigerator. And even though I sit here just talking into a microphone blankly while no one's around me, I sit here and think, what could have happened to this game? But I know what happened. It was basically the developers just didn't care. Then they post these stupid things when you open up the game saying that we do care. But you look at the game and you see it exact opposite. Like, it just, it doesn't make any sense. Like, yes, you say you're doing things about the cheaters in the game. Yes, you say that the game is very toxic. What are you exactly doing about it after a year? You're barely doing anything. You're just saying you're doing stuff. And it's just dumb. Let's speak on behalf of cheaters for a second. Like, 1 in 5 games you go into has a cheater in it, at least in my book. Like, I also do report a lot of people, probably for not being cheaters, but, like, some of the crap that happens in the game is pretty ridiculous. Like, my favorite thing is opening up the game and seeing the message of the day, and it says, cheaters not welcome. The fuck does that do? You think someone's gonna look at that and go, well, I'm gonna turn my game off? No, they're gonna be like, who cares, and skip over it. But I do love the things that they're apparently doing and how they're gonna fix everything, because there's apparently 24/7 security monitoring, can't say that a million times, all possible cheats and hacks are reviewed, planned improvements to in-game cheat reporting, 50,000 plus global permabans to date, and more updates are coming. Like, the hell does that mean? I know what it means, but, like, there's no way you're doing 24/7 security monitoring. All possible cheats and hacks reviewed, the hell, this is just like every report that comes in, doubt you're checking them. Plan improvements. This should have been done months ago. Probably about, like, released in what, March? So probably about maybe July when it was really getting bad. You probably should have done something then and been proactive. Now you're being reactive to all the people being pissed off. And then 50,000 global permabans to date. This is a fucking free-to-play game, man. Like, there's no way you can tell me that this is... They could just reinstall the game or make a whole new account. There's no, like, that's just ridiculous. You're just gonna constantly ban the same people over and over again? They could easily rank up their guns over and over. It doesn't matter to them. So they enjoy having fun by kicking the crap out of people who don't have the cheats. What a stupid, stupid way to, like, show this. No one's gonna care about this. No one's gonna have, we wanna keep Warzone fun and fair. Like, idiots. Here's my other thing that's a little frustrating. Like, and this is my last comment about the whole cheater thing. I'm very fired up because I hate the cheaters in any video game because it's obnoxious. But, like, you could have very easily at some point in time sat there and said, hey, we understand our game is completely broken right now. We know it's, like, littered with cheaters. Here's the steps we are going to take to make sure we have an anti-cheat system in by X date. No, they waited an entire year to release this. Some little comment that says cheaters not welcome, and then give what they are doing, even though they're not doing any of this. There's no way all this exists at all. They're still so far behind and so out of touch with the community that, like, this is their answer. They could have done this a while ago, which goes to my next point. The lack of information or even transparency as to what is happening in the game is ridiculous. Like, they're not being very transparent in the fact that they're doing this anti-cheat system. They just kind of brought it out and said, we did this, when it doesn't seem like you know what's going on. Information-wise, or any even transparency, I don't know, maybe I'm not using any of that correctly, but when the DMR and the Mac 11 were broken, like, just every game you went into, there was a player using one of those two guns. It was insane that they didn't even talk about it. They were talking about other random crap. Like, I've watched games like Rainbow Six Siege, when something is broken, the developer comes out and talks about it and says, we are working towards doing X. Infinity Ward, Ravensoft, Activision, who cares, didn't do any of that. It was quiet. They were just trying to figure it out, but it took them way too long to figure that problem out. It's like the beginning of February when I think they actually figured it out. And it's absurd. Like, at one point, I remember seeing online, people were going to the community director, whatever her name is. I don't know, who cares, not my problem. But people talk to her and try to figure out when's this going to be fixed, whatever, and she blocked people. Yes, people on the internet are very toxic. Like, I understand as a community director, it's very tough. But when people are very passionate about something, they want to get their answers and make sure that the game that they're paying $60 plus... because they're buying microtransactions, they bought special editions, is at its best. And they're frustrated that they're watching the game that they care so much about just burn because they don't really, it doesn't seem like anybody cares. All you guys literally have to do is give information and be transparent as to what you were doing, and people shut the fuck up. The community in Rainbow Six Siege can be, I don't think it's actually toxic at all. I think it's actually pretty fun. Is at the hands of just the fact that the developer shows that they care. You could literally do that and everything would be fine. Here's the last thing that gets me, is the constant jamming down your throat for you to buy other things in the game, meaning micro DLC or even Black Ops Cold War. And they do it by breaking the game themselves. Like, when Black Ops Cold War came out, even still, I think there was like a patch that some people noticed that the Black Ops Cold War guns were kind of like iffy. But at the start, a lot of them were pretty good. Like, the DMR and the Mac 11 were great, pure because they broke them. I don't think that was unintentional. I think they did that intentionally so that you would buy Black Ops Cold War so you could unlock the weapons, which is stupid. That is the stupidest thing you could do. It caused me to leave the game. I actually, there was a point where I didn't play the game for like 2-3 weeks because I just got so frustrated because every game was the same. A lot of the weapon variants, a lot of the cosmetics, like, people just buy them because all of a sudden it seems like the ones that have the tracers are insane. They're like, a lot of times they are literally laser beams, and people are like, well, I might as well spend the $20 on the weapon pack. That's not how you should build your game. The weapon variants shouldn't be built to be broken. Black Ops Cold War weapons shouldn't be in the game to be broken. What they should have done is taken the Black Ops Cold War weapons, brought them in, and then started to kind of take out some of the modern warfare weapons. And in that, they could have said, what guns do you like as a community to keep in the game? You could have said the Graw, whatever. That would have made 10 times more sense and kept Warzone going. They really want to keep this game going for a long time. They need to follow certain steps, kind of develop a better anti-cheat system. They need to be more transparent and more honest with this community. And they got to get rid of this stupid microtransaction BS. Like, it is terrible. This game is so heavy on microtransactions and profitability for them that they lose sight of the community, the people that are going to pay money so that way it keeps going. But that's all I have today. So I would like to thank you all for watching this video. Thank you for taking your time out of your day. Let me know what you think about Call of Duty Warzone. Do you think it's dying? Do you think it's getting better? Let me know why you think that in the comment section. Until next time, though, when we talk about something that's probably related to Grand Theft Auto, because that's all I've been playing for like the last 2 months. Bye.